Crenshaw, the Danserie, an extensive collection of short and varied dances, were issued from this shop in 1551 for unprescribed instruments. This transcription uses modern instruments in various groupings in an effort to reflect the sound of Renaissance consorts. This year, Duquesne University is very fortunate to have on its faculty a professional dance instructor, Mrs. Renee Kyle. The choreography that you will see this evening was done by Mrs. Kyle in collaboration with her students. And now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome to the podium the director of bands at Duquesne University and the conductor of the Wind Symphony, Dr. Robert Cameron.
Redburn someday.
Oh, yesterday after 17 years? Okay, let's start with, yes, I'm a famous Hollywood producer. Yes, I never made a picture that lost money. Yes, I've got that magic touch. Call it talent, whatever you want, I don't know. The fact is, ever since I've been old enough to sneak into the Ridgewood Theater in Tenafly, I've been a movie nut. Not only have I seen every Humphrey Bogart movie he ever made at least 8 times, I now own a print of all those pictures.
Q.
Why
do you think? Say it loud.
Why do you think I was so crazy to buy this house? So anyway, I went to Hollywood, I was extremely lucky, very smart, and presto, I became a producer. I love making movies. I hope I can continue doing it for the next 50 years. That's one half of my life. The other half is that in the last 14 years, I've been married 3 times to 3 of the worst bitches you'd ever want to meet. You see, they took... I gave them love, I gave them a home, I gave them a beautiful way of life. And they took every cent I got. But that's not what hurts. What hurts is that they took the guts out of me. They were phony, unfaithful, all of them. Dolores, my first wife, I caught her in bed with a jockey. A jockey! Do you know what it does to a man's self-respect to find his wife in the bed with a 4'8" shrimp who weighs 112 pounds? But as I said before, screw it. My second wife, Carlotta, she was keeping her Spanish guitar teacher. Keeping him! I never caught her, but she didn't fool me. Nobody takes $27,000 worth of guitar lessons in 1 year. Listen to what I'm saying, you. I'm in a very bad way. I've been through 3 hellish, miserable marriages, and I don't want to go that route again. So last week, my mother, who still gets the Tenafly newspaper, she shows me this picture on the front of the paper of the PTA annual outing at Palisades last year. And who was on the front, coming in first in the mother and daughter potato race, looking every bit as lovely and beautiful as she did 17 years ago? It's my last salvation, Muriel Tate. That's why I had to see you, Muriel. To reaffirm my faith that there is a decent woman in this world. Even if it's only one. Even if you're the last of a dying species. I just wanted to spend 5 minutes with you, just to have a drink. That's why I called you yesterday.
Belle knew when I was singing that old Black Magic. It's one of my best numbers. Well, he liked it so much, he jumped up on a chair, started screaming like an Indian, put his fingers in his mouth, and started whistling like a steam engine. Naturally, it made me feel good. Most of the couple was the dragon was too drunk to pay any attention to my songs. I thought he was awful cute. Attracted right from the start. But I guess it's what you might call a sexual attraction. Well, very next morning, he wakes up and hollers, yippee, we're getting married. I honestly thought he was crazy. But when I tried to reason with him, he wouldn't listen to a word. He stayed by my side all day long like a shadow. But the midnight show. If any other fella came down to the date with me, Belle beat him up. He kept telling me all week that he and Virgie would let me by the night the rodeo was over, and they'd pick me up when we got all back to Montana together. And I knew that if I was by the Blue Dragon that night, that's what had happened. So I decided to beat it. One of the other girls at the Blue Dragon, she lived on a farm across the river in Kansas. She said I could stay with her. So last night, I went back to the Blue Dragon, just sang for the first show. Then I told him I was quitting. I'd been wanting to find another job anyway. So I went by to pick up my share of the kitty, but darn it, I had to tell him I was catching the midnight bus. And of course, they had to go tell Bo when he came in a little after 11. He paid him $5 to find out. So I went down to the bus station. I haven't even got my ticket, but here come Bo and Bert. He just steps up to the ticket window and hollers, 3 tickets to Montana. I didn't know what to say. So he dragged me on the bus, and I've been there ever since. And somewhere deep down inside me, I got a funny feeling I'm going to end up in Montana.
Here's the whirlwind flying east, Harbor, France, in the Sopworth Camel, searching for the infamous Red Baron. I must bring him down. Suddenly, anti-air aircraft fire from beneath my plane. Ah, na, 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 you can't hit me. Actually, though, flying aces never say na, na. Well, back to business. Dread this fog. It's bad enough I have to fight the Red Baron yet alone in flying weather like this. After 17 years? Okay, let's start with, yes, I'm a big famous Hollywood producer. Yes, I never made a movie that lost money. And yes, I've got that magic touch. Call it talent, whatever you want. I don't know. You see, ever since I've been old enough to sneak into the Ridgewood Theater in Tenafly, I've been a movie nut. Not only have I seen every Humphrey Bogart movie he ever made at least 8 times, I now own a print of all those pictures. Why do you think I was so crazy to buy this house? So I went to Hollywood. I was extremely lucky and very intelligent. And presto, I became a producer. You see, I love making movies. I hope I can continue doing it for the next 50 years. That's one half of my life. The other half is that in the last 3 years, I've been married to 3 of the worst bitches you'd ever want to meet.
Okay, cut.
Phone company. It's a monopoly. Where are you going to go without them? If you get too hot with the phone company, you wind up with 2 Dixie cups and a thread. Chicks who work for the phone company. I can see them. Their names are Terry, Winnie, and Midge, and they wear cotton pants and Kresge's with the days of the week on them, right? But always the wrong day. Tijuana is the greatest place in the world to make telephone calls. Hello, Telefonicas at Tijuana. Yeah, I want to call Beverly Hills. I want Crestview 4-9678.
Okay, that's going to be $7.50.
Oh, what's the matter? I only have $4.
Who do you think?
They'll take anything. Chiclets, a sweater.
I had a girl over there. What would she do if I went over and asked her if I could have lunch with her? I'm sorry. Over there. I want to...
Who was it, Mike?
Girl eating lunch over there. I wondered what she'd do if I went over and asked her if I could have lunch with her. She'd probably laugh right in my face. It's hard on a face when it gets laughed in. Place next to her on the bench. There's no reason why I just couldn't go over there and sit right next to her and have lunch. Well, I could do that right now. All I have to do is stand up. I'm standing up. I'm sitting down.
Norman, big red-headed boxing woman. Her husband is a Mercedes-Benz dealer, we ain't talk. Mal doesn't like her. He doesn't want me to see her. He doesn't want her to be my friend, and he doesn't want her to come to our house. Mal can't stand Charlotte Corman. He's been having an affair with her for 8 months. I had to stop seeing her 3 times a week so he could see her 4 times a week. These are the times we live in, Barney. And you know what my proof is? He told me. 2:00 a.m, leans over, taps me on the shoulder and says, I've had an affair with Charlotte Corman. Who asked him? When he tapped me on the shoulder in the middle of the night, I thought he wanted me. Do you know what it is to wake up from a sound sleep with a dry mouth and no eyelashes and hear that your husband is getting it from a woman you're not even allowed to see for lunch? And you know why he told me? He explained it to me. We're living in a new, guiltless society. You can do anything you want as long as you're honest about it. Aren't we lucky to be living in such a civilized age? In the old days, I would have gone to my grave ignorant of the wonderful and beautiful knowledge that my husband was spending his afternoons humping Charlotte Corman. When he told me, I didn't say a word. I went down to the kitchen. I made myself a cream cheese and jelly sandwich on date nut bread. And that was the last time in 8 months I tasted food. I estimate going 4 times a week, I should be through with Dr. Margolis in about a year. And then when we both think I'm ready, I'm going to get in my car and drive off the Verrazano Bridge. In the meantime, I'm very depressed.